Welcome to our second video in our series about fingerprint scanning. In this series, what we do is answer the four most commonly asked questions we receive at Microkeeper about our fingerprint scanners. In the first video, what we did was gave you a high-level overview of how fingerprint scanning gets used in businesses across Australia to speed up payroll. In this video, we'll answer the second question. How do you install? So what I'll do in this video is I'll unbox this thing together with you, install the relevant software on my computer, and start enrolling the first fingerprint scans. As you'll notice from this video, installing a fingerprint scanner at your workplace is quite straightforward, but there are four things that we need to make sure of that you have before we can get started. Firstly, an active internet connection. Ethernet is probably the best way to go, but Wi-Fi will do just fine as well. Second, a computer with a free USB port. Third, make sure we're running Windows 7 or above. And lastly, an active Microkeeper subscription. All right, you've got all those four things sorted? Great. Let's see how we go with installing this thing. So the Microkeeper fingerprint scanner comes in this box. And when you open it up, you'll know quite quickly that installing it will be straightforward because it comes with only two things. Firstly, this card, which will tell you how to get started. Now, I'm not usually one for reading instructions, but for this video, I'll make an exception and I'll actually follow all the right rules. And then secondly is the fingerprint scanner itself. And I'll hold that up nicely to the camera so you can see it with the Microkeeper logo. All right, that was pretty straightforward. Let's see how we go. Firstly, it's asking us to plug in the fingerprint scanner into the PC, point of sale, or smart device. Now, I've got my laptop set up right here, and I'm going to plug it in into my free USB port. And as you can see, it's working because it has a little blue light going in there. Next thing, I'm going to follow the self-setup and visit the guide on Microkeeper's website. I'll show you that on screen so that you can follow along. We'll go to microkeeper.com.au/guides. All right, once we're on a guides page, what it tells us to do is to download this software. Now, Microkeeper itself will run in the cloud, but this piece of software will take care of the fingerprint scanner. All right, and then we come to this screen and it'll ask us about our username and job ID. For username, what I need to do is find the username of the business. And to do that, I go to login and then I go to settings, general, global, and then my username can be found right there. I'm gonna copy that with Control C and then I'll paste that into my username box with Control V. Pretty straightforward. Now, the second thing that it asks for is job ID. Now that one's optional. I'm going to leave it blank, but I'm gonna show you how to find that job ID if you want to link this fingerprint scanner to a specific job. So basically what will happen is anyone who clocks in with this specific fingerprint scanner will not only be clocking their hours, but will also be assigned the job that's linked to this fingerprint scanner. I'm going to go to the menu, jobs, then jobs again, and then I'm just going to mouse over the ID column to get the job ID. But you can also just leave it blank. And what will happen in that case is Microkeeper will check on the roster what job is assigned to the person clocking in, and we'll just make sure that that relevant job is assigned to that shift. Next step, I'm going to enroll my fingerprints. All right, to do that, click here, enroll employee. And what you will see is that it'll ask us to scan our right index finger four times. Now I'm going to show you from up close how that gets done because it's important that we get a reliable scan. So what you need to make sure of is that you put your finger high up on the glass and press down firmly. So we'll do that four times and then repeat on the other side. And you get given a code. Now we're going to use that code to assign this fingerprint to the correct staff member. And that's going to be the last step, so it's pretty straightforward as you can see. Now, to assign that code to the right person, follow along. We're going to go to the menu, payroll, NFC, and fingerprint, and you will see there a list of fingerprints that need to be assigned to the correct person. All right, so I'm going to connect this fingerprint to Michael Scott, press set. Perfect. And that's all done. And so that means that next time I come in and scan my fingerprint, immediately unlocked on. And so that's all that needed to be done. We've unboxed the fingerprint scanner, installed the relevant software, and enrolled the first fingerprints. I hope you enjoyed this video and that it was helpful to you. If it was, make sure you check in on our next video where we'll answer another question about fingerprint scanning. In the meantime, if you want to find out how this works together with the rest of our software package that includes core HR, rosters, timesheets, and payroll, you can go to microkeeper.com.au and find all relevant information there. Thank you so much for your time. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time. Bye.